Entonces, los 50 con la 96.
Yes.
Para 16. Therefore, I don't think to the answer to the opposite question. This court would like to clarify at the outset that in course of his argument, Mr. Lauter and Sun Council appearing for the petition had much emphasized on the ground that the judgment at the 19th, 2023 is unsustainable. On the ground that petitioners who are necessary party to the earlier litigation were not added as opposite parties and they are not given an opportunity of hearing in violation of principle of natural justice. So that the ground taken in the application concern not much emphasized was less on such ground that the senior counsel appearing and grabbed the petition. Therefore, this court will proceed to adjudicate the new application as well as the recusal, keeping in mind the factual background of the present case, as well as the fact that one counsel for the petitioner assailed the order judgment dated 19/5/2023 on the ground that said judgment is required to be renewed on the ground that the petitioner were not added as opposite parties and as such they are not heard before delivering the judgment dated 19/5/2023. On the analysis of the ground other than the non-member parties, on the analysis of the ground other than the non-member missing parties, as taken in the review, as well as the petition, this court is of the considered view that such grounds are based on merits of the matter, which can only be challenged by filing an intra-court appeal as provided in law. Then finally come to page 207.
Appearing
for the petitioner argued that this court in judgment at the 19/5/2023. Although as referred to the issue of non-member of the missing party in paragraph 14 of the judgment, however, the same has not been answered while delivering the final judgment. In this context, this court would like to observe that we are reading a paragraph 14 of the judgment review, that the same has been mentioned with reference to the pleading in the counter affidavit of the opposite party. It is further clarified in course of final hearing of the matter, none of the counsel appearing for the opposite party neither raised the same question, nor made any emphasis on such aspect of the matter. Therefore, the contention that the issue has altered is that the same has not been answered would not be fair argument in the factual background of the case. But then the civil counsel appearing for the unit itself was not the counsel in the matter to whom the judgment is delivered is being sought for to be renewed. Then, sir, kindly come to page 216. I have already shown to have said the Royal Advocate General referring to that judgment has specifically argued during the course of argument, which has been noted by the Honorable Single Judge, that non-member party is fatal and on that ground, each application is bound to be dismissed. Then, as we kindly come to page 216, para 37. Para 37. No, sorry. Para 37, 216. In the opposite background, this court would now record the final issues formulated in the preceding paragraph. The first point that was formulated by this court was as to whether the ground taken in the review petition are good grounds, and accordingly, a review petition is entertainable on such grounds. Question mark. In reply to the said grounds, this court is of the considered view that the ground with regard to non-gender of necessary party, which was emphatically argued by the non-senior counsel, is definitely a good ground. So far, maintainability of the review petition is concerned. With regard to the other ground taken in the review petition, this court would like to record that such grounds are based on merit of the issue, which has already been decided by this court in the earlier writ application. Therefore, in the event the petitioner agreed by the finding of this court, they should have no advice to challenge the same by finding an intra-court appeal. That's the first issue is answered accordingly. So then finally come to page 219. The single judge held that this is a definitely good ground, so from non-member listed party that review petition. Then finally come to page 219, para 39, which is the concluding paragraph 39, page 219. In view, just get it. 19 or 39.
Yes.
In view of the answer arrived to the question number 1 and to question number 2, this court is at the considered view that both the petition as well as the removal petition at the instance of the petitioner are maintainable. So far, the acceptance of such a new petition and new petition and maintainability thereof is concerned, this court is required to apply the underlying principle of Order 37, Rule 1. As in both the above-noted application, this court has called upon to review on its own judgment dated 19/5/2023 to entertain such applications to require the petitioner required to establish that they are necessary party to the earlier writ application, and therefore the earlier writ application as well as the judgment dated 19/5/2023, which is sought to be reviewed in the present writ petition, are vitiated by non-member of necessary parties. And analogy the question as to whether the petitioner was necessary party to the previous writ petition, this court has already held in the preceding paragraph that they are not necessary party to the previous writ petition, as no right was personalized in their favor by publishing the final select list for appointment to the post of ASO. Moreover, the process of selection was continuing during the relevant rule, particularly Rule 6. In question, such error was operated present records. With regard to the then current time, we come to next paragraph. With regard to the observation of the principle of natural justice and approving the opportunity to petitioner is concerned, this court would like to refer a judgment of the Honorable Court Union of India versus Vikas Kumar reported in so-and-so. Next, since the petitioner was not necessary party to the earlier writ application and the further error in the selection process was apparent on the face of the record, by applying the principle as reflected in paragraph 12, Vikas Kumar Shukla. His court held that rectification of such error of this mistake is permissible without giving a hearing to the other party. If any, then it's wrong. Thus, this court found no basis of argument once in Johnson appearing for the petition that the judgment rendered by this court in the previous petition initiated in any manner in Indian party. Is appearing to this court and not Muslim party and by not providing such parties an opportunity of hearing before giving a direction for ratification of the error in the selection process, as it cannot constitute that petition can be in any manner be called as acting party. Now, also, can you look to the judgment? I have given the copy of the judgment so far there. Nalyan the party is concerned. The first judgment at this Honorable Court, incidentally, I was a counsel there. The rest of looked to the running page 7. I have page mark.
Page?
I have page mark in my note I have given. The rest come to no more citation I have given.
Yes.
And the rest kindly come to running page 7. That is reported in 2015 CFD, page 102.
Yes.
Sir, this is Orissa Public Service Commission by the petitioner. Remember that that's where the respondent. Was the kindly come to paragraph 25. Go start from paragraph 25. Where is the kind of family? Wait, so. Sir, let me read paragraph 23 issues. That is at page 17. One is page 17. Upon hearing the parties.
Yes.
Upon hearing the parties and on perusing the documents, including SCR, MCR, the following issues are for consideration of this case. One, whether selected candidate of the preliminary examination were required to be made parties before the round tribunal. Then, sir, kindly, other issues are not addressing, but let us come to paragraph 24. Coming to issue number 1, let us scan the various amendment and prayer made by the opposite party in the original application. At paragraph 3 of the original application, opposite party number 1 makes it clear she challenges the illegal selection made in the preliminary examination 2011 by the APSC by adopting a wrong and illegal marking procedure. Then, sir, kindly come to page 25, paragraph 25, same page. Thus, one thing is clear that on one ground or another, rule number 1 has argued that the result of the preliminary examination conducted by the petitioner has been vitiated, and accordingly, she prayed for setting aside the result of the preliminary examination. As indicated earlier, about 5,823 candidates succeeded in the preliminary examination. As per Rule 1 of 91 rules, read it clause 2 of Schedule 2, of 1991 is clear that candidates qualifying the preliminary examination shall only be called and commissioned to appear to main examination. Thus, the candidates who qualified in the preliminary examination got the right to appear in the main examination. In such background, it is needless to say that the selected 5,823 successful candidates have a right to appear in the main examination as per 1991 rules, which is rule made under the proviso to Article 309 of the Constitution. See, the select list containing roll number 5823 successful candidate have been set aside by the law tribunal, it clearly offends the right to sit in the main examination. As per the law laid down by the court judgments of the Honorable Supreme Court, in the decision in Udit Narayan Singh's so-and-so case supra, it is clear that persons who are going to be directly affected or against whom relief is sought are necessary parties, and they should be named in the petition. It has been made clear that parties in whose favor an order or notification has been issued, and when the same order or notification is challenged, the same parties are necessary parties. In the same effect is the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court in H.C. Kulwant Singh Supra, even as per the decision in the case of Prashant Ramesh Chatter's case, they are resolved in the civil service main examination was under challenge. The Honorable Supreme Court has held that non-inclusion of candidates selected in the civil service main examination was fatal. It can be noted here that even though a candidate selected in the main examination has no right to be appointed at that stage, but has a right to appear in the examination, has a right to appear in the interview in India's Civil Service Employees Association case, the Honorable Supreme Court has made it clear that the candidates whose names are there in the provisional selection do not have the interest, public right, in protecting and defending that select list. The ruling of decision rendered in Sadanand Hota's case supra makes it clear that the Honorable Supreme Court was not satisfied with the course of action taken by the High Court in inviting objection from the selected candidate who had never bothered to vote parties. In this context, the decision cited by Dr. Mahapatra in B. Prabhakar Rao's case is factually distinguishable. In that case, ordinance was challenged and no relief was claimed against the individual. So far, the decision in Rajesh Kumar Supra cited by Dr. Mahapatra is concerned, the same is also factually distinguishable. Though the court therein took note of non-inclusion of parties, no finding was recorded on its impact on account of the nature of direction given by the Honorable Court at paragraph 19(4) on the judgment. But then, sir, kindly come to para 28, next page. So far as the decision in Sankarsan Das case, supra, as cited by Mr. Mahanthi's concern, in that case, the matter related is whether a person has a right of appointment of being selected or being selected. Here, issue is not right of appointment, but a right to sit in the OCS main examination on the principle relating to precedents as laid down in the AI 2011 Supreme Court 1989. There exists no dispute as to their applicability. Then para 29. Para 29, let's just keep it up. And come to para 31, go at the bottom. Para 31, go at the bottom. The judgment of the tribunal was set aside, it was remitted back. By remitting the matter, that the Honorable Division will say. Para 31, go at the bottom, last but 3 lines. We have to expedite the matter. We further direct the petitioner to place it, to supply a sizable number of names and addresses of successful candidates at preliminary examiners to the opposite party number 1, who have the petition before the tribunal. If a request is made to that effect, thereupon opposite party number 1, who will be at liberty to complete them as in the representative capacity and respondent before the land tribunal. Because so omega, we expect the state government to process keep over that. In the next judgment, which was cited by the Honorable Advocate General, which was noted by the Honorable Civil Judge, that no answer to that in the judgment, can we come to page 22? Siraj, that judgment, page Siraj versus High Court of Kerala, Let's come to paragraph.
Well, let me sir. Honorable Crown Minister.
Sir.
Mr. P. Ramtha, and I also grant me the petitioner. Call this matter next.
Intrigue.